In SFOS v21.5, we're taking active threat response to the next level with the introduction of NDR Essentials for Firewall. Sophos Firewall threat feeds began with Sophos XOps, a managed threat intel database of over 1.4 million threats. Then in SFOS v20, we introduced MDR and XDR-driven automatic response actions. In v21, third-party threat feeds were enabled, allowing customers to integrate external threat intelligence. And now, with v21.5, NDR Essentials introduces cloud-hosted NDR machine learning models for Firewall, which detect network patterns, uncover unknown threats, and identify dynamic domains without impacting firewall performance. Today, we'll demonstrate how NDR Essentials works and how to enable the new feature in the firewall. Afterwards, we'll show how to test and view detections and finish up with some advanced troubleshooting. Before beginning, there are a few caveats to keep in mind when enabling NDR Essentials. You'll need to have SFOS v21.5 or later and an active Xtreme Protection Bundle license. If you don't have the Xtreme license, don't worry, there's a 30-day trial available. Also, NDR Essentials is supported for MSP or managed service providers. XGS hardware is currently supported for NDR Essentials. Virtual and cloud devices are not supported at this time. NDR Essentials supports physical, VLAN over physical, and lag interfaces, along with bridge interface members that belong to LAN and DMZ zones. Lastly, this new feature is not currently supported for HA active-active mode. Now let's see how NDR Essentials works. NDR machine learning models run in the Sophos Intellix cloud. They detect using domain generation algorithms, DGAs, and analyze encrypted traffic using encrypted payload analytics, or EPA. When a device reaches out to a C2 server over TLS, the firewall sends the encrypted flow to NDR for deep analysis. NDR detects anomalies, assigns a threat score, and returns the data to the firewall. It then adds indicators to the threat feed list and takes actions like logging, alerting, and reporting for any further requests. Now let's go over how to enable NDR Essentials in SFOS v21.5. To enable NDR Essentials in Sophos Firewall, navigate to Active Threat Response, click the NDR Essentials tab, then enable NDR Essentials. Then select the interfaces you wish to monitor. These are usually interfaces that carry the most internet traffic or pose the highest risk of C2 communication. Lastly, adjust the minimum threat score and apply the configuration. You've successfully enabled NDR Essentials. Sophos Firewall will immediately begin real-time analytics and monitor flow counts as traffic is processed. Next, we'll run some NDR test detections. Navigate to sophostest.com. In Sophos Test, click Network Detection and Response, then click Download File. Once the download has finished, unzip the file. The file itself is not malicious, but will mimic attack-like behaviors to trigger a detection. For more details on how the test works, check the relevant blog linked in the video description. Next, open a command line window and navigate to the folder containing the downloaded file. In my case, I've left the file in the Downloads folder. I'll CD or change directory to my preferred platform, which in this case is Windows. I'll type the downloaded file name. If you enter --help, you can view more information on the file and a list of available commands for it. I'll enter --all, and the file will begin running an attack-like sequence. After a few minutes, check the firewall UI to see the increment flow count and the detected indicators of compromise. To view the detected threats, click Threat Indicators. A pop-up will appear displaying the threat indicators, scores, and names. Next, I'll copy the threat indicator. Then, I'll navigate to that domain. As it tries to connect, it will be detected across multiple places. It can be seen as a detection in the control center, along with a suite of details on the detected threat. Click on Active Threat Response Report for even more information. You can view who attempted to access a malicious destination, or the discovered threats and which firewall modules detected them. It can also be seen as a log in the Log Viewer page under the Active Threat Response category. And in Sophos Central, within the Report Generator section, you can see the ATR report, along with a list of all detected responses. And from the central dashboard, you can also view them by navigating to Threat Analysis Center, then Detections. This will display all detections including NDR, MDR, and XOps. Clicking on any of these detections will provide more details. For each of these detections, a detailed email notification will also be sent from Sophos Central and Firewall. Lastly, for any advanced troubleshooting, there are two main log files to be aware of. The first is the ndr.log file located in the /log directory. This log captures all the configuration-related events for NDR Essentials. The second log is the ndragent.log file, which records any communication between the firewall and the cloud, as well as the processing of indicators of compromise. These two log files are the key resources to reference for advanced troubleshooting. And that covers the all-new NDR Essentials for SFOS v21.5. I hope you found this useful. Check out the documentation for this video in the description. For further assistance, view and post questions on community.sophos.com and go to techvids.sophos.com for more great videos like this one. Thanks for watching.